Okay, so we're going to do this. Yeah, I know. That is amazing. How do you do that? Yeah, well, I am going to tell... Tell? I'm going to tell you. Not tall. Tell. Show you. Maybe. Yeah, I'll show you. Yeah, I'll show you how to do that. Are we in recording? Yeah. And yeah, Blender is also totally free, so anyone can download this and do this, which is amazing. And yeah. So let's check it out. Okay, so first thing you want to do is grab your computer, open it up. Go into Blender. So, in the default tab, we go to compositing. And we enable nodes and backdrop. You can get rid of the render layer, so press X to get rid of that. And go to output and get a viewer. To import our footage, we use Shift A and get a movie clip node. So we want to open up our movie clip. And there we go. And so what you want to do now is connect these two to the composite and the viewer. That way you can see the movie on the backdrop. You can press fit here to fit the background into this window here. You can also get rid of these. We don't need these. Okay. So what we want to do is we want to shift the RGB channels and shake them a bit so it looks like they're shaking or like this glitch effect. So what we want to do is go into converter, separate RGBA. We're not going to use the alpha channel since we don't have an alpha channel. Go in and grab a combine RGB2 and connect the image to the separate RGB and the combined RGB node to the viewer and composite node. So what you can do now is click on separate RGB and combine RGB and press Shift A and then go to group and make a group. This will make it much easier to organize. And here we want to go into distort and get a translate node. And we actually need three of these because there's a red, green, and blue channel. So let's go ahead and duplicate them with Shift D. There we go. And then you can go ahead and connect the red channel to one, the green channel to another, and the blue channel to the last one. And then the output to the combined RGB. There we go. So the image basically looks normal now, but that is because we haven't like shifted the images. So if we do that right now, you can see what is going to happen. So that is the effect that we are looking for. Go ahead and reset that. What we want to do now is go to converter and go to math. Here we want to make it a multiply node. You can change this value to 0, and we don't care about the other value right now, and we need 6 of these, so go ahead and duplicate them with Shift D. There we go, and then you can connect the value to each X and Y. Yeah, and so now we want to make a keyframe on the upper value on the multiply node. So hover over it and press I, and it will turn green. There we go. Open up the add. Go ahead and press Shift A and go to input. Get a value node and connect these to the value below the one that we just keyframed. There we go. And what we can do now is also keyframe the value node. So we can change that to 0 right now. There we go. And once they are keyframed, they will appear in the animate section of this program. So let's go to that. Let's go on the editor type and go to graph editor. Right now you don't see anything, but go to node group here and these will appear. And so the bottom value is the value node, and we don't care about that right now. And so if you go into these, we can see that they're totally straight. And what we want to do is press N to get this panel right here. Go into modifiers, add modifier, and add noise. Yeah, and so you can copy this by pressing this button here, and then go into the other keyframe and paste that in there and change this so the noise will be different in each animation. And you can do this for every value. Okay, so the last keyframes are like the amplitude, how much it will affect the video. So right now it's set to 0, which means that it will have no effect. And so if we go back to the node editor. Okay, so now I found the keyframe that I want the effect to appear. And so I go into value and I change that to like maybe 200. That looks a bit much, but we'll do that for now. And we press Y while hovering over to keyframe that. Let's go back one keyframe and set that to 0 because I don't want the effect to appear there at all. Yeah, and then we go forward like maybe 2 seconds, which is 50 frames. There we go, and we wanna set that to 0. And let's keyframe that. Yeah, so that's it. If you like this video, why don't you subscribe? Push a little that red button. Yeah. Or you can like the video if you liked it. Otherwise, dislike it if you wanna. Leave a comment. That's always nice. And yeah, I'll reply.